Hello all, I welcome you to my channel. Today I'm going to show you how to install the latest version of IntelliJ IDEA, version 2024.2 on the Windows operating system. And after that, I'm also going to show you how you can easily create a simple Hello World Java project within our IntelliJ IDEA. So do watch the video till the end. I can guarantee if you watch the video till the end, you'll be successfully able to install your IntelliJ IDEA. And you'll also know how to write simple Java projects. And if you face any issues, you can always comment in your comment sections, and you can also ask your questions on our Instagram. I'll definitely going to help you. Now to install IntelliJ IDEA, you need to first simply go to favorite browser, and then you need to just simply search over here IntelliJ IDEA download and hit enter. So that's going to show you this www.jetbrains.com. So just simply open this link and it's going to redirect to the official site of JetBrains. So this link I'm going to provide right in our description. So here you can see that we have Windows, Mac OS and Linux. So depending upon what operating system you are using, you have to proceed with all that. So for Windows, you need to switch to this Windows tab and then you need to scroll down and you will get this IntelliJ IDEA Community Edition. So here you need to just simply click on this download button and immediately it will be going to start downloading our IntelliJ IDEA. You can see it is rightly started over here. I have already downloaded it, so I'll cancel this. I'll minimize my browser. I'll go to my download directory, and here you can see that our IntelliJ IDEA is already been downloaded over here. So let's just simply double click on the exe to start installing our IntelliJ IDEA. So it'll ask you for administrative privileges. Click on yes, and there you go. Welcome to IntelliJ IDEA Community Edition setup. So let's first minimize our download directory. And here into just simply click on next. So this is where our IntelliJ IDEA is going to be installed. Everything is totally fine. Only thing that you need to check is how much space you are having on your C drive, because we are installing it on a C drive. So it is very important so to have the available space. So for IntelliJ IDEA, you need to have 2.6 gigabyte of free space. So I'm having that. So just check that and then click on next. So here under installation options, you'll get lot of checkboxes. So you need to check it one by one. So IntelliJ IDEA Community Desktop Shortcut is going to create. Similarly, you'll need to also check this add open folder as project. So whenever there is any folder lying on your Windows, so just right clicking on that, it's going to add this open folder as project as an option. So always check that. I'll use Java, so I'll select .java. If you want to do Kotlin, you can also do Kotlin. I'm going to make a detailed video about that also, you'll get on this channel. So if you want to be a Kotlin developer, you can, you know, select all these other languages and you can, you know, proceed with installing IntelliJ IDEA. And next thing is you need to also check this add bin folder to path, very important step. Just simply click on next after that. So it's going to create a JetBrains folder, totally fine. Just simply click on install. You can see our installation is rightly begun. Also desktop shortcut is created over here. Right, so you know this, you know, takes some time. You can always click on the show details. You can see how it is, you know, extracting each of the file and then installing it. So it will take some time, couple of minutes maybe. So by the time our IntelliJ IDEA get installed, let's, you know, discuss about our channel Kiki Syntax. So here regularly I'm posting lot of coding related videos, so please do subscribe our Kiki Syntax channel. That will really motivate me to make more such videos. And also if you want, you can also subscribe our Kiki blogging channel. And recently I have also created one account on Instagram, so you can ask all your doubts over there. I'll always try to help you, so please do follow our Instagram account. And here let's wait for a couple of minutes. So welcome back, and now you can clearly see that our IntelliJ IDEA is successfully installed. So you can, you know, always reboot your system now. So you need to select this reboot now and you can click on finish to reboot your system. So, you know, please do reboot your system and then we are going to again come back to this video. So let's do it. So welcome back. So after successfully rebooting your system, we'll be again landed over to the desktop, and you can see our shortcut is also created over here. So IntelliJ IDEA Community Edition 2024.2. So just simply double click on the shortcut to start launching our IntelliJ IDEA. So you can see it is rightly started launching. and there you go. So our IntelliJ IDEA is rightly open, so it is telling whether you'd like to import your previous settings. So in my previous videos I have installed Visual Studio Code, so it is telling whether you'd like to import all those settings from Visual Studio Code, or you just simply want to skip all those import and you want to start afresh. So let's click on skip import and we'll start everything from scratch. So welcome to IntelliJ IDEA. You can maximize this. So here you can click on this new project. So let's create a new project. So give a project name. So let's give the project name as Hello Everyone. You can give any project name as per your wish, and it's going to create over here. So it's going to create a IDEA project directory, and within that it's going to create Hello Everyone project. You can see this is how it's going to look. All right, so next important thing is Java. So we are working on Java, so this is what it is selected, our Java JDK path 22. Again, I have made a detailed video about how to install Java, so you can follow that video to install Java. Or else what you can do is you can just simply click on this drop down and you can, you know, click on this download Java. So when you click on that, see, it is rightly started downloading your Java. You can select the folder and you can install your Java. Since I have already installed Java, so that path you can see that it is already selected, right? This registered JDKs. So you know, if you haven't installed Java previously, you can download it from here, and then again your path will get automatically registered. Or if you have previously installed Java following that video, in that case you'll see that Java path is already recognized. So now that's all you need to do, just simply click on create. So it's going to start creating our Java project within IntelliJ IDEA. You can see it is rightly started reformatting our code, and here is our project. So it's going to also open our main.java file over here. You can see that file is also opened over here. So let's first maximize it. So here is our project, then here is our src folder, and within src folder we have our main.java file, and that main.java file is also opened over here. And here they have also given one sample code. So we have a public static void main, and within that we have system.out.printf. Then we are just simply printing hello and welcome, and then we have a simple loop over here, so that's going to print 1 to 5 natural numbers. So here in this statement we are just simply printing I equal to 1 2 3 4 5, so those natural number it's going to print sequentially, right? So now everything is totally fine. You need to just simply click on this run button and it's going to start building your project. So in a first time it might take some time, don't worry, just, you know, have some patience. You can see it is rightly started building our project, and it's going to show you the output on our console. You can see hello and welcome, then it is printing 1 to 5 natural numbers. So that's how you install latest version of IntelliJ IDEA on a Windows operating system. Please do subscribe our Geeky Syntax channel, that will really motivate me to make more such videos. Along with, if you want, you can also subscribe our Geeky Ski vlogging channel. So that is basically all about this video. Thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.